Hey vapers, I just did a video on wicking the Aqua Fogger V4, the Orchid, and the Kayfun style atomizer. If you watched that video, you'll know that the density of the cotton is key to building and wicking an atomizer, the Kayfun Orchid Aqua Fogger type style atomizers. The density of the cotton is key to that. I hope you picked up and some tips from the video. Excuse me. And so I just wanted to do a short vapor production. This is the fogger that I just re-wicked in the previous video, and hadn't had any dry hits off of it. I've been vaping a few times with it. Not a problem. Let me do a vape for you. Vaping nice, hits nice. I'm vaping it at 15.5 watts. That's 4.3 volts. And it's a 1.2 ohm build. Okay, that's pretty good. No dry hits. Still no dry hits. So it's vaping pretty good, and this is a high VG juice that I'm using. It's Cape Fear. The flavor is Chicora. The brand, like I said, is Cape Fear. It's very good juice. It's high VG. It's something like 80 VG, 20 PG. It's vaping good. Something to keep in mind, though, if you're building lower builds, lower ohm, lower resistant builds, you might want to consider using even less cotton, because with the lower ohm and the lower resistant builds, you're going to be the cotton, the wick is going to have to wick more juice up to the coil. Okay, so you want to ensure that you're not using so much cotton that when it swells up in those vertical juice channels, that when it gets saturated with juice, the cotton doesn't swell up so much that it restricts the flow of juice up to the coil. It's very critical with a Genesis style atomizer, with the Aqua Fogger Kayfun Orchid style atomizers, it's critical, but not as critical as it is with a Genesis style atomizer. And if you've gone through and looked through some of my videos, you'll see that I've addressed that the cotton wicking situation with the Genesis style atomizers. With a regular dripping atomizer, it's not as critical as with the this style tank atomizer. Just keep that in mind if you're going with lower resistance, lower ohms on your builds. You might want to reduce the density of the cotton even more, reduce it even more, the density of the cotton more in the vertical juice channels. Now some of you are getting, say, oh, it's leaking. Well, okay, then you're not using quite enough cotton in the vertical channels. Some people are saying, oh, I'm getting dry hits. Well, that is because you're using too much cotton in the vertical juice channels. The cotton is too dense. It's not. It's actually restricting the flow of juice up to the coil. So keep those in mind. And as I said in the other video, Robert Green, who makes some thought-provoking videos in the vaping community, he had brought this up, and he said that there was no universal technique to wicking an atomizer because people's draw is different, their builds are different, or whatever. But really, the key to wicking with cotton is the density that you use, the density of the cotton that you're using. And with this style atomizers, these tank atomizers, the density that's of the cotton that's in the vertical juice channels is critical. And like I said, if you're building a lower ohm, a lower resistance build, then you'll probably want to use even less density in the vertical juice channels. But there again, you want to be mindful that you're using enough to stop the free flow of juice up to the, you know, into the chamber, the chimney, the chamber where the coils are. You'll want to use enough cotton to keep it from free flowing into the chamber. But not enough cotton, not dense enough to actually restrict the flow of cotton. So while there's no universal set standard for every single build when you're wicking cotton, the density does play a key role in how it will wick. Okay? So anyway, y'all vape on. Vape strong. Check out the Obsessive Cotton Disorder Facebook group. If you have any questions about wicking or using generally using cotton in vaping atomizers, we'd love to have you come and join the group and participate. You can contact me there or through the Facebook, whichever way. If you like my videos, please subscribe to them. And if you've learned something from them, if you've picked up tips or whatever, you know, please pass them, you know, recommend them to other people that you know that are vaping that may have questions or you know, may have some trouble with how to get it the wicking correct with when you're using cotton. So thanks for watching. Vape on and vape strong.